Hello, I'm Saul, Nitya retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity. Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. Now we are approaching the end of the age, and it's very interesting. Tribulations are going around. You won't have peace no more because we are in tribulation period. And anybody who will be, who will want protection, he should seek the protection of the tribal fathers. Father protects, mother feeds, and then they can live peacefully in the houses and land they occupy, mother. But if they're not seeking the protection of the tribal father, and they become Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, Jew, Christian, etc., of the physical self, of appearances and not of qualities, then they will be killing each other. They will burn and kill each other. No protection. Now, to tell us all these things, we have an establishment of the chosen people in Israel, which are the demonstration nation of the world, and through them we learn all these moral laws. So let's, I have written something and you will enjoy it. The chosen people were set up as an ideal nation by Yahweh, Brahma, Khuda are the same thing. They are the creator of this body. This body is created by Yahweh. The soul inside me is of Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm. Yahweh, to lead the world in the moral laws and spirituality. Of Abraham is Adam, Sarah is Eve, and the promised land is Garden of Eden. They were living in the company of the creator, Yahweh. Yahweh is the creator of this pot. Some are elephants, some are lions, some are ants. All these things that you see living, the soul in that one come from God. So I have learned a lot from these chosen people. You know, Iraq was the birthplace of Abram. Yeah, that's where from he left, like Sadhu, you know. He, Abram, with Sarah and with his cattle, they left Iraq area to come and settle in this promised land that was promised by Yahweh. And so he set up like an Adam. The previous surname or anything, he left it away, like sadhus do, you know. And then he set up here as an ideal Adam and Eve with the promised land as the Garden of Eden. Now the destruction, you know, now they are started, was started from Iraq, that Saddam Hussein has weapons of mass destruction. And that was not true, because one of a major general of the army, who is leading a Christian ministry, international, let me show you his card. So, here is the card of that gentleman. The email address is wrong, you know. It's www.rabbinicdisciples.org.uk. And so he is the Major General, retired, Rody Porter. He came to deliver a sermon to us on a Saturday morning breakfast. And people asked him, he was in Iraq, people asked him if Saddam Hussein had weapons of mass destruction. He said, definitely not. So Blair and Bush, they spoke from the core of their heart a pack of lies, which are called blasphemy, because it is against Holy Spirit. So you can see, politicians, they are number one blasphemers. And to destroy that country, what type of acquisition they built against it. So that was the cradle of humanity. That's why the farmer Yahweh picked up the person from that Iraq area, and not from India or from any other part. And it should have been one which is of Semitic race, no other race. Semitic race welcoming both white and black. They are not discriminating against anyone. So he was there and he sent no weapons of mass destruction, and so Bush and Blair, they were blasphemers. And the main point is this, you know, this Major General, he's running the Christian Ministry of International for the soldiers. It's a good thing. But Britain, being a nation of shopkeepers, they don't want to offend anyone. Gospel truth is offensive because it hits at the hypocrisy of the people. It exposes the hypocrisy. So this man should have been going on the rooftops to expose the hypocrite Bush and Blair. But he won't do it. It is by the grace of our supernatural Father Elohim Allah Parbrahm that you preach gospel. If you don't have His grace, you can't preach the gospel. You have to carry your own cross. So with this, let's carry on, you know. Iraq was the birthplace of Abram, who became Abraham. Why the U.S. started the destruction of countries starting with Iraq? Because these people, they are getting bundled up in Israel, are the tares. Tares means sons of the Most High Satan, Al-Jamar Al-Aqsa. That's why Jesus told them, you know, in the temple, when they brought to him a woman caught in adultery, which would have produced, which was a sinner and produced just a bastard. And then those boys, mostly of the Judah tribe, they were not happy. They wanted to catch him so they can accuse him, because the proclamation a person is a sinner or not sinner is that of the priest. But Jesus was a royal priest. It was above him. So he did not proclaim any judgment on moral laws, whereas John the Baptist did. That Herod marrying the wife of Philip is illegal, is not lawful. Whereas the temple priest, they were stooges of Herod, so they kept their mouth shut. As you see, the Church of England headed by Queen. So anything which is against the wishes of the Queen, they don't open their mouth. Church of England headed by Queen is the head of Mammon. So is a church of Mammon, of Satan, whereas the Salvation Army people, they are the nearest to God. And these people there, no wonder the soldiers who died in World War I, World War II, and viceroys of South Africa and India, who bring in money to them, that was the blood money of the poor people. And they are, when they died, they said they glorified God. And that is the right thing. God, which is Mammon and not our merciful and Mammon-free God. That's why people, when they join the first community of the Church of God headed by Christ Jesus, they got rid of Mammon altogether by disposing of their property. And whatever they proceeds they had, they gave it to the administrator, and he passed it on to the poor people. He did not put it into the bank, as this Pope is doing. Pope is Antichrist. So you will soon see a lot of tribulation in the world. And the chosen people, they are the demonstration nation of the world. And we should study their history and everything to learn the moral laws. In God, you know, we don't hate anyone because we exercise love called agape, unconditional divine love. So God blesses everyone alike.